Welcome back to the BlockBench tutorial for your street model. Today we'll be looking at the basics of textures, and I'll be giving you 3 cool tips at the end of the video. When working with textures for your street model, you should have just one texture for the whole model. But you can also duplicate the texture to recolor it so that you have more textures in-game. The maximum texture size for your street model is currently 4096x4096 pixels. The texture will automatically become bigger as you add more cubes to it. To add a texture, you can press the button called Create Texture on the left side of your screen. Pixel density decides the size of your pixels. A lower pixel density makes the pixels bigger because there aren't as many pixels. You can keep the other options as they are for now, but if you want a bit more space between the faces on the texture, you can also check the padding option. Since the cube is relatively big, nothing goes wrong when you add the texture. But if the cube is smaller, you might end up seeing this error. To fix this, go to File, Project, and then change the UV mode from Box UV to Perface UV. Now everything should be fine, and there shouldn't be any holes in the cube's texture. Also, if you need to find your cube's location on the texture, you can find it by pressing the cube in Edit mode. When you add more cubes, you also have to add them to the texture, so that this doesn't happen. To add a new cube to the texture, you have to press the button called Append Elements to Template. Let's first see what happens when you don't uncheck this option. The problem here is that all sides of the cube are stacked on top of each other, but when you do uncheck it, it makes sure that all sides of the cube have their own spot on the texture. Since I appended the cube twice, you can still see the old spot on the texture, but it's not actually used for anything. To remove it, go to Paint and right-click the texture, then find Edit, and press Clear Unused Texture Space. Now let's check out the Paint tab a bit more. On the right side of your screen, you have a color picker and a palette. You can switch between them or show both at the same time. You can also change the picker type like this. Up here, you can see the recent colors you've used. If you find the color you like, you can save it to the palette. You can also load one of the default palettes, or create a blank one so that you can make it from scratch. To make this a bit easier, you can use a plugin that generates a palette. To find the plugin, go to File, Plugin, and search for Color Gradient Generator. Now let's check out the toolbar. First, there's the simple brush. You can change things like the brush size, density, and shape. There's also the smooth brush, which has a bit of gradient that you can adjust with the brush softness. With the copy brush, you can copy things, and also use it to make patterns. The paint bucket can be used to paint the whole cube, faces, or specific colors. And if you use the paint bucket directly on the texture, you can change the specific color on the whole model. The eraser tool completely removes color, so you can actually see through your cube. Then there's the draw shape tool, which makes it easier for you to make squares and circles. And then there's the gradient tool, which makes a gradient depending on how far you move your mouse. Let's fix a few errors you might run into when you're texturing your model. The first one is texture overlapping, where two textures are sitting on top of each other. An easy fix is to move one of the cubes so they won't be as close together, but if you don't move them enough, you might still be able to see the overlapping from a bit further away. The next error is the miscolored lines that you might see on the edges of your cubes. They usually aren't visible in Minecraft, but if you want to make them less visible in BlockBench, you can install the plugin called Plaster. Then just add the new tool to your toolbar, and use it on the cubes you want to fix. Now I'll show you 3 bonus tips. The first thing I'll show you is how to make a drawn hair texture. First, make a simple cube, and then use the paint bucket to erase all the faces after you appended the cube to the texture. Then you can draw the hair like this. The second thing I'll show you is how to make a glowing texture. All you have to do is change the name of the group so that it starts with YSM Glow. And here's what it looks like in game. The last thing I'll show you is how to merge two textures. Right now, both cubes are pink because they share the same spot on the texture. I'll also import the blue texture and move it a bit so it won't be overlapping with the pink one. To merge the two textures, go to Paint and right-click the lower one, then press Merge onto texture above. If you have any questions, just let me know down in the comments and I'll try to help the best I can.